Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Rob Blanchflower Connected Careers or Connected Franchise Series here in Madden 15. So Rob Blanchflower, the second string tight end for the Pittsburgh Steelers, wants to become that first string tight end, but he's got a long ways to go to oust John Carlson out of the top spot. I believe he's an 82 overall. And Blanchflower is a 75 overall. I believe that's where it stands. So we're going to have to live with being second string tight end for now, because you guys want me to make him earn it on the way up here. So the Steelers, who started off red hot but have cooled off a little bit, looking to get back on the winning track here in Baltimore today. The Ravens are just 1-5 entering this game. So there's a good chance, even though we're on the road, that we could come in here and get a victory. Well, let's see how things go. Now, I'd like to think it kind of depends on how much the Steelers are willing to play young Rob Blanchflower, because when he's in the game, he tends to get good results and help his team in the category of at least catching passes and getting them downfield. Now, we're at the mercy of a lot of the times them simming him to a point where he can play in a two tight end set. And then when we get out there, we got to do a lot of things like calling no huddle offense to keep him on the field. So here we got a play, and he's going to go over the middle, and the very first pass by Roethlisberger is picked off. Not a good way to start the game at all for the Pittsburgh offense, setting a bad tone, and they do give up a score after the turnover. Here's a short pass that's going to go for longer yardage. Nice job by the Steelers getting a first down right there, and that'll be Greg Jennings making the play. We'll see here as Jennings turns a short catch into a longer gain, coming across the field and making a nice play inside the 40-yard line of the Ravens. So does it lead to points? No, it's 10-0 now in the second quarter. Ben is back to throw, and he's going to lob this one to the sideline. Great play right there running underneath that. That is your tight end, the man we're here to see, Rob Blanchflower, making the play. Nice throw just over the defender. And nice concentration for Blanchflower to run to the sideline, make that catch, and have both feet in bounds. So here we got a play action again, and they're going to throw to Blanchflower again. Hey, look at this, is working out. Should be another first down. So he's still in the game with about 3 minutes left before halftime. And they're going to go to him again. He's open. Throw it. Oh, yes, he gets both feet down. Nice catch right there. If he throws it earlier, he can probably run down the sideline and score a long touchdown. But instead, Ben opts to loft this over by the sideline. So there you go. Look at that. It gets both feet down. Makes a very fine catch indeed. So we're going to run the football now. No, nothing doing out there. Blanchflower tried to get his block, but they overwhelmed with the number of defenders over there. And now you've got Ben going down, and he is injured. Roethlisberger not getting up. Oh, that's not good. Hopefully he's not knocked out of the game for good. Looks like he's clutching his back or something, but it looks like he's all right. He's over on the exercise bike. He should return later in the game. So here we go in a 10-10 ball game. Now Pittsburgh comes back. Roethlisberger is there. He's firing downfield. And is it a catch? No. And now you've got Antonio Brown down on the field. Oh, man, you got major players in this offense getting hurt in the first half. Just 4 seconds left before halftime. Quick toss to Blanchflower. He will make that catch. It'll be a first down, but time will expire. So that only helps in the way of stats for our tight end. But we've got a 10-10 game at halftime, which is better than it looked when we were down 10-0. So let's see if we can continue and maybe get a lead here. Ben's going to throw quickly underneath, and we'll get some yards right there. It'll be third and inches. Maybe should have called for a run play right here, but got to make the most of our opportunities. He'll make that catch right there. Blanchflower going right down the hash marks there and will make the catch. Another first down catch for Blanchflower. We've got first and 10, still 10-10 game. Ben has time to throw. He will do just that and get another first down. This will lead to a field goal attempt at the end of this drive. The drive stalled out, but they do get the lead 13-10. So 13 unanswered points. Looks good for the Steelers, right? Then the fourth quarter happened. 17-13, 24-13. Blanchflower is watching this all from the sideline. 27-13. Coach Tomlin's like, I give up. We couldn't win it. We had a lead in the second half, late in that third quarter, but then things go awry and we lose another game. This one to Baltimore. They're now 2-5. Man, we needed that win. Couldn't get it. So a 27-13 Ravens victory. That kind of sucks. Blanchflower goes 5 catches for 75 yards, a 15-yard average. That was nice. He could have been out there a little more, and maybe he could have helped out down the stretch there when they had the lead, but I guess not. So we got to settle with what we were handed today, which is a loss. Yeah, that's frustrating. Really frustrating. So what is next on the calendar for us? Oh, goody. It's the 4-2 Arizona Cardinals. We got a winning team coming into Pittsburgh. Yeah, and we are on a losing streak here. I believe, if I remember correctly, we went 3-0 and then lost 3 in a row. So we are a team of streaks for sure. Let's see what we can do at Heinz Field today, taking on these Arizona Cardinals. Let's knock them down a peg. Roethlisberger hoping for a little bit better game. He'll be going against Ryan Mallett, really? Okay, Ryan Mallett for the Cardinals. This is a scoreless game right here when that's a first down catch. Short yardage, but it will move the chains. And Blanchflower likes it. He's going to celebrate. Yeah, well, let's see the replay on here. Just a quick throw, but he is reliable there with the catch and getting the first down. So it's a 7-7 game now in the second quarter. You can see how sporadic the play is for Blanchflower getting on the field. Yeah, we just got to go all over the map to see what he gets done. He makes a short catch right there. Not for a first down. This will be later on, and that'll be a catch for John Carlson, the starting tight end. Let's see his play right here. Makes the catch, turns up the sideline before going out of bounds. So it's got the Steelers in a good spot. They're down 14-13 in the third quarter here now. We're jumping all over the place yet again. Look at this adjustment. Didn't like the route he was covered, so he turns back and somehow makes a catch there. How does Ben get him that ball? I don't know. But it was a crazy play right there as he reverses course and he zings that ball into him. It could lead to a potential field goal here, and it is good. Pittsburgh will take the lead once again late in a third quarter, up 16-14. But look at this. Arizona storms back, 24-16. Is this a repeat of the last game? Starting to look like it, but the Steelers hoping to get into a position to score here, 24-16. At the goal line, Ben's going to throw short, and it's in. Touchdown. That's Le'Veon Bell. The halfback gets the pass and gets in the end zone. Let's see how this happened exactly. He was out of screen. Ben gets nailed, but look at that. Le'Veon Bell is wide open there at the sideline, makes a catch and spikes it. So this is going to end up short, though, on the comeback. 24-22, the Cardinals take it. Another frustrating end to a game for the Steelers. They're now 3-4. This is getting rough. If you remember last year, we only won 3 games, and I was bragging about, hey, look at this. We've already reached last season's mark. Well, maybe I spoke too soon because we might just end up losing all the way out here and ended up with the same record. So Blanchflower, 3 catches for 20 yards. Definitely could have used more work here in this game. Feels that he could have helped put him over the top, but that is not to be. So we just, once again, have to push this away and move forward. Give us somebody we can beat. Who do we got next? Give us somebody good. Who is next on the schedule? Oh, yeah, okay, send us to Denver against Peyton Manning. That's not exactly what I had in mind. Wow, okay, sometimes the NFL schedule can be very cruel to a team, and this looks like one of those times right here. The 5-3 Denver Broncos with Peyton Manning, our next hurdle to cross if we want to get a victory and get back in our winning ways. This is not the game you would think that you would be successful in doing that with this man coming out here and leading his offense. Peyton Manning will usually carve you up. So let's see how it goes for the Steelers. Get into game action. When will we see our man Blanchflower? Well, look at this. It's 24-6. Pittsburgh making a tough catch and getting hit hard right there, but he hangs on. It's going to be first and goal after Blanchflower's catch, his first of the game. Look at this, though. They apparently have forced some turnovers on Manning and have done a nice job on the road. Can they hang on to this, though? 24-6 here in the third quarter, looking for a touchdown pass, and there it is! Blanchflower makes the catch for the touchdown, his second of his career. All right, and it comes against Denver. Nice job. Let's see this again. He is going for that pylon. Roethlisberger puts the ball on him, and there it is. Secures it with two hands. Touchdown, Rob Blanchflower. Big one right there. Only two catches so far today, but one being for a touch. And Tomlin loves it as his team is winning 31-13 right now. So this is going to be our breakout game. Interesting. There's another big hit, but another catch. Second and seven now. Under 5 minutes to play. Looks like another first down, but ooh, we got a problem here. That's John Carlson, who's not getting up. The first string tight end, remind you now. Yeah, he is grasping at that leg. Going to be a strained knee, but we're going to sub him out. We're going to put ourselves in here. Yeah, Blanchflower. Yeah, of course, right? Got to lean towards our guy being the starter for a while he can. Makes a catch right there, but it's going to be fourth down and five. They'll opt for a field goal. It's 34-20 now. Ben going to throw to Blanchflower, and that might seal the game right there. Denver's got to start using their timeouts. Under a minute, and there you go. The Steelers win it 34-20. Unfortunately, when Blanchflower had a chance to be the starter with Carlson on the bench, we were kind of in a mode to run the clock out and just win the game. So we didn't really get to show off, but there you go. A 34-20 win. At least we get another victory. So we do indeed have more wins than we did last year with four. We have that secured already. That's not a high goal to be chasing, but at least we have that to fall back on. So Blanchflower, five catches for 42 yards and the touchdown. That's the big spot right there. He gets the touchdown in a victory. So we go on the road and beat Denver. All right. Okay. So that is how unpredictable an NFL schedule can be sometimes, as we lose some games we thought we would win and vice versa. So next up, the 5-3 Cleveland Browns come to town. We'd love to win this one and push our winning streak to two games. Blanchflower wants to see the field more. Hopefully he can. Come on back for more Rob Blanchflower Connected Careers. We'll see you later. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.